Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with the fifth video about the script manager how-to. In the last video we had a short overview about how the script list was created with all the CSS and code involved. And with this video we will have a closer look about the to-do list, the standard to-dos and the to-dos which have already been done. This input area will get its own video. Okay. Let's open the code. The first element that you can see is this element, which is a template. Then there is the checklist macro, which creates this element, and the checklist done, which creates this element. Then there is the toggle me macro, which creates this open close here. Yeah, there are some graphic glitches. I don't know where this comes from. Maybe from the virtual machine that I'm using to record this stuff. So, okay, this is the checklist. Let's have a look where it is. If we open the script footer macros element, there are all the macro definitions that are used for the footer element. So that we are searching for the checklist. Have a look. Checklist. Here it is. It does not much, it just calls the to-do body with the tag and the prefix. And there is the checklist done, which also calls the to-do body and the tag done. Why do I cover these elements again? It's just for easy description. So it's easy for me to explain that there is a checklist and the checklist done. And then in the details, we have a closer look where it comes from. So it's the to-do body, and the to-do body, sorry, is very, very similar to the script overview. It first creates a div, then it defines a table class, which gives us the background and the border, and then we have a view to-do grid element. We know this grid stuff already. In the last video we did discuss it. There is the to-do grid. Where is it? View to-do grid. Here we have three elements. It's 5EM, which is the done element, which is a fixed size, and then one fraction and two fractions. Very, very similar to the script grid that we had in the last video. And in the last video, I also showed you how you can create your own development test environment to play with these variables. So if you haven't seen it yet, just have a look. Okay, so there is the grid definition. Then we have the header, the different boxes. The first header is centered. It is the done text. Then there is the title and the comment. If you have look, done, title, comment. Then there is the list creation with the list filter, with the list widget. Then it says create filter with the tag and prefix, and create filter is here. So it disables all the tiddlers which have a draft off element. So we only want to see the real tiddlers. It checks for the tag to do, and it checks for the tag done, which is hard coded here. So this is not very good. As I told you in the first video, I wanted to explore the different possibilities. And then see if different patterns come up with the code and the code duplication and so on. And here we definitely have some room for improvements. So some elements are hard coded as this done, and some elements are variables. So here we have some space for improvements. Okay, create filter back. So it checks for draft off, it checks for the tag to do, it checks for the tag done. And then it creates the list. Then there are the different boxes. So we have the first box gets a text done, the second get link and get comment. And these are here. Get comment is just standard text and reads the comment field. View widget is used to read the comment field. Then there is the get done. It creates a checkbox and uses the tag done. checkbox for the tag, done. It's this one. And then there is the get link. It's a little bit more code here, because we need two possibilities. First we have the standard link, and then we have the link with the strike through. Yeah? And we need to create two different links depending on the tag done. Yeah? So there is a list filter. It checks for the tag done. It checks for the title and the tag done. And if this filter creates a value, then it creates the link and the strike through. Yeah? So if both is valid, so it has a tag to do and a tag done, it creates a link with a strike through. If it just has the title, so if the element is empty, it just creates the link. Yeah? And that's the possibility with a list widget to create the if-then-else structure. Yeah? So if the first element is not true, then work with the else. And in this case, else is empty message. Yeah? So you can play a little bit with this and see how it really works. Yeah? So, but this gives us a nice possibility to use the same code with to do and done. Yeah? But yeah, the backside of the coin is the code is a little bit more complicated. Yeah? So we could duplicate the code and get easier code, or the code is a little bit more complicated, but we can reuse it. Yeah? As I said, there is some possibilities to improve this stuff, because some of the elements are hard-coded and some are not. Yeah? Yeah, that's basically it for the to-do list creation. And as I told you, this element will get its own video, because it uses a completely different grid type, which needs some more explanation. Yeah, I hope this helps you. Have fun.